Taking you beyond the ballot box tonight, some Florida felons will basically be locked out of the November election. A federal appeals court ruled Friday the state can keep former felons from voting if they owe court fines and fees. On Your Side's Haley Harrison spoke with a Jacksonville criminal defense attorney who filed a brief in support of Florida felons.
Amendment 4 returned Florida felons' right to vote back in 2018. But attorney Mitch Stone says that Friday's decision still blocks more than 750,000 people from the ballot boxes.
Voting is one of the most important things we do in a democracy, if not the most important thing we do. And so when we take away someone's right to vote, that's a pretty serious thing.
Mitch Stone, who's also president of the Florida Association of Criminal Defense Lawyers, is disappointed in Friday's decision. He says voters overwhelmingly passed Amendment 4. But attorney Stone says for many Florida felons, quote, completing a sentence means paying off all court fees and fines.
You have people who basically get out of prison who don't have the ability to go get a great job, start a great business, and so that they don't have extra money. They basically have enough money to survive. And we're asking them to take the money that we need them to survive with and pay the court system in order to get the right to vote.
Since early 2019, a large team of plaintiffs have been fighting so people don't have to worry about their felony conviction costs before voting.
We want to give them the ability to get back into society. And by keeping them off the voter rolls, you're not abiding by the spirit of that law, that constitutional amendment that was passed by the people of the state of Florida.
So what's next? After their loss in federal appeals court, the plaintiffs are meeting now to determine how to move forward with the litigation. Now, attorney Stone also told me that different groups are getting together and raising money for Florida felons who still have legal financial obligations. In Jacksonville, Haley Harrison, First Coast News, on Your Side.